Hey everybody, how you doing? This your friend, your brother, your elder, Follins. It's time for noonday prayer. I like to start around about 12:15 to give those that normally know we are in prayer to start making adjustments. I know some people are at lunch. I see people coming in. See you, Tracy. Love you for real. I love you, love you, love you. Today's noonday prayer, those of you, start sharing them on your page right now. I'm trying to connect my other page. But we thank God for how noonday prayers has been a blessing to everybody and how people have been inboxing me, telling me how much they really, really enjoy noonday prayer. So I'm so forever grateful. Thank you. I see the saints coming in. It's prayer time. So put it on your page. Go ahead on and like and share. Today's noonday prayer will be focusing and praying. I see you, Talisa. Love you. I see the regular noonday prayer people coming in. Today's noonday prayer is on divine connections. We want God to give us divine connections in this 2020 year. We want divine connections. We want connections that are godly to be beneficial to our life in this year. So many times we do things just because, or we do things because we've always done it that way. But I want God, I love you so much, Talisa. I'm believing God for you. I'm believing. See you, Wanda. I see you. Tracy made sure that I added you. I had to delete a few people so I could bring you on in. My first page is full. Those of you who are coming in, and please do me a favor. I want you to go to the YouTube, and hit Dwight Follins. And I want you to subscribe to that if you haven't already. I promise you all, once I get 1,000 people, YouTube will be a blessing to me. I know more than 1,000 people. YouTube will be a blessing to my ministry, and I need it. Lorenzo, my Chicago brother, love you for real, man. I believe God for you that this will be a great year for you, Lorenzo. Lorenzo has an amazing heart. He's a great guy. He is a beautiful spirit. We need more people like that in the kingdom. Sister Denise, a woman of God, this great lady of and shepherd of the Lord. I love you, Sister Denise. I'm believing God for total recovery and restoration for you, that this will be a great year for healing to you in Jesus' name. I'm believing God for some great things. Mother Washington, I see you coming in. Mother Washington, we've already decreed and declared that this is going to be your year for you and your family. For those of you who are coming in, go ahead on and share it to your pages. I'm waiting on a few more people to get moving and so we can come in, because it seems like when I get ready to close out noonday prayer, that's when everybody want to flood it and everybody want to come in. But prayer is essential no matter when you come in, as long as you get in there. And let's let the Lord, I see the numbers are going up now. More and more people are tuning in. It's noonday prayer time, you all. Noonday prayer is called the seventh watch. The seventh watch of the day. It's the seventh prayer watch. Those of you who don't have it already, please show your love and support. This is my first book. It's a guided prayer journal. All the readings up front. The rest of it is praying and writing. And when you read, pray, and write, God releases answers prayers. Glenda, that's my cousin, like no other. I love you. Glenda gave a testimony of how noonday prayer was a blessing to her and everything God said to her and manifested. So, Glenda, I'm believing God is only the beginning of great things. Good to see you, Daniel Williams, coming in. My sister Jackie, she's coming in. Jackie in the D.C. area. I see saints from everywhere coming to take part in noonday prayer. We're going to go ahead on and start our prayer. I see the saints coming in, and as they're rolling in, those of you who are already on here, you can write the scripture down for them or write our prayer focus. Today's focus is divine connections. Divine connections. I want you to begin to write it in there. I have great connections in 2020, or I have good connections in 2020. That's what we want God to give us. And our focus scripture, our first one, is in Ezekiel. It seems to be a lengthy reading, but it's going to help our purpose. But today's noonday focus is for divine connections. Our first reading is in Ezekiel chapter 37, and it's a familiar text, and I don't like to pray without reading God's word. I love you, Glenda. Love you for real. I see you, lady, Shonda Pace. I love you. May the hand of the Lord touch you. Thank you for coming on into noonday prayer. I'm believing God. Everybody that's in noonday prayer, the Lord drew you here. And this prayer focus is for divine connections. In 2020, God's going to change your company. Y'all, we accept it. We believe it. Some folk you've outgrown. Some people you need to release. And some people you need some great things to start coming. See you, James Grant. That's my friend. We hadn't spoken in a minute. I need to talk to you, bro. It's always good to see you. I'll be in Atlanta this weekend for our prayer clinic. The prayer clinic I do every fourth Sunday in Atlanta. So I want to see my Atlanta people. See you, Jason. But my Atlanta people, I want to see you Sunday at 6 at Faith Apostolic, 1840 Thomasville Drive, Southeast. And I promise you, God will meet us there. But let's go to Ezekiel chapter 27. We're going to Ezekiel chapter 27. And then we're going to 1 Corinthians 1 and 10. But Ezekiel 27 is very unique. It says, the hand of the Lord came upon me and brought me out in the spirit. Brought me out in the spirit of the Lord and set me down in the midst of a valley, and it was filled with bones. Then he caused me to pass by them all around, and behold, there were very many in the open valley. Indeed, they were very dry. And he said to me, son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord God, you know. And again, he said to me, prophesy. In this chapter, you're going to see the word prophesy more than at least 6 to 7 times. It's going to say it over and over. He said, prophesy to these bones and say to them, O dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God of these bones, surely I will cause breath to enter into you and you shall live. Verse 5, that's trying to tell us that whatever we prophesy, whatever we say, is what we're going to see. And Ezekiel is telling us how God gave that to him. Today's prayer focus is for divine connection. Verse 5, thus says the Lord, God of these bones, surely I will cause breath to enter into you and you shall live. Verse 6, Ezekiel chapter 37, I will put sinew, that's muscle, that's tissue, on you and bring flesh upon you, cover you with skin and put breath in you and you shall live. Then you shall know that I am the Lord. Here it is again. So I prophesied as I was commanded, and as I prophesied, there was a noise, and suddenly a rattling of the bones came together. A rattling of the bones came together. Indeed, as I looked, and the sinew and the flesh came upon them, the skin covered them, but there was no breath in them. So he said, prophesy to the breath, and prophesy to the breath, prophesy, son of man, and say to the breath, thus says the Lord, come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe on the slain, that they may live. So I prophesied, and he commanded me, and the breath came, as he commanded me, and the breath came to them, and they lived, and they stood on their feet, and an exceedingly great army. Here it is, verse 11. Then he said to me, son of man, these bones are the house of Israel, and they indeed say our bones are dry and the hope is lost and we ourselves are cut off. Therefore prophesy and say to them, thus says the Lord, behold, O my people, I will open your graves and cause you to come up from the grave and bring you into the land of Israel. Then ye shall know that I am the Lord when I have opened the graves, O my people, brought you out from your grave. Here's the last verse. I will put my spirit in you and ye shall live, and I will place in you your own land. Then ye shall know that the Lord has spoken it and performed it. Thus says the Lord. We have divine connections. Divine connections. Why Ezekiel 37? Why did we have to do that? Because when he told him to prophesy to the bone, every bone connected in the right place. You didn't see a thigh bone going to a shoulder bone. You didn't see a knee bone going over to the ankle bone. Every bone went in place. So that's what we're believing God, that as we prophesy over our 2020 year, everything that is dry and desolate will receive life, and everything is going to fall in place. Everything, you didn't see a neck bone going to the hip bone. The hip bone knew which way to go. I see you, BB. That's my brother. That's my friend. But today's noonday prayer focus is for divine connections. Yes, we will be in Atlanta. I said it earlier. We'll be in Atlanta this Sunday at 6 p.m. at the Faith Apostolic Church at 1840 Thomasville Drive, Southeast. So listen. This noonday prayer focus is for divine connections. We just read Ezekiel chapter 37, verses 1 through 4. Those of you who are in noonday prayer, begin to type it in for those coming in. Ezekiel chapter 37, verses 1 through 14. And our New Testament reading I kind of like to go to the Old and New Testament to confirm what we're praying for. And we're praying for divine connections. We're going to go to 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 10. Here it is. It says this: "Now I plead with you, brethren, by the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that you will speak the same thing, and that there will be no divisions among you, and that you will be peaceably joined together in the same mind and in the same judgment." We're decreeing and declaring. That is 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 10. I see Estanya Roberts. We grew up together. We grew up in the same neighborhood. I'm believing God that 2020 will be one of the best years, Estanya, that you and your family has ever seen. Congratulations, too, on those grandbabies. I believe, God, on your grandbaby, that the Holy Spirit is blessing you. I see LaVon. Thank you, LaVon. LaVon made me some bean soup, and it was so good. I'm going to post about it later. But thank God for those of you who are coming into Noonday Prayer. Today's Noonday Prayer is about divine connections. That's what you put down in agreement. And as you type it, we're agreeing upon it, that we have divine connections in 2020. We have great godly connections. We read Ezekiel chapter 37, verses 1 through 14. We read 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 10. 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and 10, Ezekiel chapter 37, verses 1 through 14. We want God to send us divine connections in this year, new connections, people who are going to feed into us, people who are going to support our vision, people who are going to tell us how to move from now to next, people who are going to guide us in the spirit to our next level of living. We need divine connections. Kind Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for this Noonday Prayer. Thank you for those who are tuned into Noonday Prayer. Holy Spirit, you are welcome. Holy Spirit, come in and be with us. Holy Spirit, come in and commune with us. Come in and sup with us. Spirit of the living God, fall afresh upon us. Just as you told Ezekiel in chapter 37, you told him to prophesy to the bones. And God, we're in Noonday Prayer today to prophesy to every bone, every dry area in our life. We're here to prophesy to everything that we thought was dead. We decree and declare that everything will be rightly joined together. Everything will be rightly connected together. We will have nothing wanting, nothing lacking, nothing missing in this new year. We decree and declare that we have divine connections. Today's Noonday Prayer, Holy Spirit, you place it on our hearts to pray for divine connections. Connect us with the right people that's going to cause our life to be better. Connect us with the right people that's going to cause us to flourish and prosper. Connect us with the right people that's going to cause us to live in abundance. Connect us with the right people that's going to correct the wrong things that we've been doing for so long and show us the right way to do it so we can live better lives. God, we have divine connections. In Jesus' name. Now, Holy Spirit, forgive us of all of our sins, transgressions, iniquities, anything that's hindering us from your presence, anything that's hindering us from living our full life. God, anything that's hindering us from having divine connections, forgive us. Wash us in the blood so when we call on your name, we'll be able to get an answer. We decree and declare, God, that we don't want anything between our soul and our Savior. Holy Spirit, come in and cleanse us so that we could stand rightfully and boldly before the God our Father, and he will hear our cry. He will heed our call in the name of Jesus. Those that are coming in to this Noonday Prayer, today's Noonday Prayer focus is for divine connections. We decree and declare that God is connecting us with the right people this year. No more frivolous, no more meaningless relationships, no more relationships that are not beneficial to us. We want in 2020 divine connections that's going to take us from our now to our next, because we realize that our next is greater than our now. So we decree and declare that we have divine connections. Good to see you, Bishop Johnson. I love you, man. Bishop Armis Johnson, a great man of God. Good to see you, Charlie Brown. I love you, man. I'll see you in a few. Good to see you, Gabby. I thank God for you coming in. I think I saw my best friend Robin too. We have divine connections. Good to see you, Junior. We decree and declare that we have divine divine connections. We read Ezekiel chapter 37. Those you are coming in, type it in there. So the latecomers or people who are coming in will understand, and they'll read our daily meditation. Ezekiel chapter 37 verses 1 through 14, where he said, prophesy to the bones. Every bone connected to the right spot. The shoulder bone knew where to connect to. The hip bone knew where to connect to. The knee bone knew where to connect to. The ankle and the foot bone knew that they needed to be connected. So that's what we're praying for, that in 2020, we get connected to every beneficial area of our life, that there'll be no disconnect in Jesus' name. And we also read 1 Corinthians 1 and 10. 1 Corinthians 1 and 10. Says, now I plead you, brethren, by the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, that you all speak the same thing, and that there be no division among you, but that you be perfectly joined together in the same mind and in the same judgment. Somebody type that in there for me. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 10. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 10. We are believing God and we're praying for divine connections at this noonday prayer. Ezekiel chapter 37, verses 1 through 14. That's what we're believing God for, divine connections. We want every friendship, every relationship, every fellowship to be divinely connected. I see my good, that's it, sister, my big sister Jackie. We're connecting for everything to be beneficial in every area. I see Evangelist Katana Campbell, a mighty woman of God. We're praying for divine connections in 2020. I see my classmate coming in, Sister Whitaker Gold. I love you. God bless you. God, Brother Edward Barnes, I believe God for you, man. Divine connection. Angela Camp, divine connections. I'm praying that people will grab hold of these noonday prayers. Even when you replay them, send them to somebody else. Send them to somebody else and say, you need to hear this. It's quick. They're not that long. Allow people to get them and be blessed by them, because we need divine connections. Can I tell you, the right people will move you in the right area. When you're around the right people, you can't help but live right lives and live better. I like to be around people that's going to challenge me to be better in Jesus' name. I don't want to be the sharpest knife at the table, but I don't want to sit with a whole bunch of dull spoons either. I want to sit around some people who got something to contribute in Jesus' name so that we can all live better lives. That's our prayer focus today. And God, we trust you for divine connections. Now, God, even in this prayer for divine connections, we pray for divine healing. Connect us to the right doctors, the right physicians, the right people who are not going to just treat illness, but cause us to be cured in Jesus' name. We decree and declare a divine healing will take place. Connect us with people who've gone through what we're going through in our bodies, and you healed them, so we'll know how to be healed and live a whole life. God, we're sick of just being treated. We want to be cured. We want to be healed in Jesus' name. We decree and declare that our bodies are healed because of the stripes on Jesus' back. We decree and declare that our mind, our spirit, and soul is whole because the wounds in our Savior's side. When Jesus told us that it is finished, it covered every disease, every sickness known to man. So we are healed. We pray divine healing for those that are sick and shed in, those that got family members that you're taking care of. We speak healing now in Jesus' name. We decree and declare that before the middle of this year, we'll be able to testify that our God is a healer, that our God did it again. Extend the life in the name of Jesus. Extend the life. You told us in Psalms 91 that you will satisfy us with long life. And not just satisfy us to be a lot older and ill and older and sickly. We want to be older and well. We bind and rebuke every sickness, every form of dementia, Alzheimer's, HIV and AIDS, high blood pressure, low blood, diabetes, every sickness, every form of cancer. We bind and rebuke it now. We send you back to the pit of hell, and we decree and declare that the people of God are healed in Jesus' name. Come on, saints, begin to type in there under the comments. Let me know you stand in agreement with this prayer today. I have divine connections. I see you, Napoleon. I love you, Minister Napoleon. He's one of our youth leaders at our church. I decree and I declare today's noonday prayer focus is for divine connections. Read Ezekiel. Somebody type the scriptures in there for me. Ezekiel chapter 37. verses 1 through 14. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 10. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 10. That's our meditation. Scripture meditation focus is for divine connections in Jesus' name. Now listen, if you're watching this noonday prayer, I want you to be a supporter. Please, please sow a seed. Go to the Cash App and do $ prayer clinic. That helps me with ministry, y'all. Ministry requires money. And people will go online and order shoes, purses, and pocketbooks and all that other stuff. And that's fine. I like nice things too. But let's support kingdom things. When you see people trying to do some kingdom things, I need you also to go to YouTube and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I need 1,000 people. I know more than 1,000 people. I need you to please call your friends and ask them to do that for you, to do that for me. Once I hit 1,000, YouTube will be a blessing to me in ministry. And I'll be able to stream live from YouTube. I'll be able to upload all of my services on there as well. So, but I just need to get that 1,000 people. So help me. I decree and I declare to you who are watching that we have divine connections in Jesus' name, that God is opening up things that have been closed for us for years. And he's, I don't know about it, Sister LaVon, I don't know about nobody else, but I want God to connect me with people that have wealth, people that has wisdom, people that have the ability to move me to my next level. And sister, that's what I'm agreeing with you on too, that we need God to give us fresh relationships with people that believe in us, people that could push us and say, I believe in you, people who are going to invest in us. That's what today's noonday prayer focus is for, divine connections. See you, Sister Sonya. Sister Sonya Young has got a powerful ministry dealing with young people. And this prayer, you stumbled on the right day for the right for noonday prayer, Sonya, because this prayer is for the divine connections. We want God to connect us divinely with the right people. We read Ezekiel chapter 37, verses 1 through 14. We read 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 10. Ezekiel 37 says, when he told him to prophesy to the bones, all the bones fell in place. No bone went to the wrong area. You hear me? The arm bone didn't go to the hip. The ankle bone didn't go to the shoulder bone. Every bone fell in place. So as we prophesy over our 2020 year, we want everything to fall in place. We don't want this to be a barren year. We don't want this to be a dry year. We decree and declare that it is a verse 14 of Ezekiel chapter 37 says this, I will put my spirit in you. And you will live and you will be in, and it says, and I will place in you your own land and you will know that I, the Lord, have spoken and performed it. We decree and declare that God is going to put his spirit in us and his spirit is going to draw the right people, but it's going to repel those that are fighting against us. It's going to repel those that's been with us 3 or 5 years. And you do know you can have people who follow you, but really don't believe in you. You do know you can have people connected to you who really are not for you. But we want God to replace them this year. Replace them with people that's going to lift us. Replace them with people that's going to gather us and hug us and encourage us and tell us to go forward and do the things of God. Kind Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you again for this noonday prayer hour. We have divine connections. You are connecting us with right people. You are connecting us with people who care about us. You're connecting us with investors. You're connecting us with people of favor, people of influence, people of wealth. And we decree and declare that before March, before June, we will have divine connections that will take us to the next level. We decree and declare that before we get to the middle of the year, the hand of the Lord will have already shifted our relationships. And we say, yes, we give you a yes. We give you, I need some people to just start typing, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. It's okay for you to touch my relationships. Yes, Lord. It's okay for you to touch my connections. It's okay for you to touch everything concerning me when it comes to relationship. Because some of us are comfortable with folk that are not going anywhere. But we want God to shift us. We want God to change our relationships. Even if they're not moving, if they're not going in the upward direction, y'all, if you know me, you know I have a motto. I only move in two directions, up and forward, up and forward. That's what I'm only moving up and forward. And I want God to connect me with other people that's moving up and forward. That's it, Gabby. That's it, Lakeisha. We decree and declare that this year, Lady Pace, that's what we're praying for this year, that the Holy Spirit is giving us divine connections. I'm tired of dealing with things over and over, repeat situations. situations repeat stuff. I need God to touch my relationships, touch my connections. And that's what we stand in agreement with. Talisa, that's it. God's going to send another investor, somebody that needs your knowledge, somebody that's willing to invest in the plan that you have. Angela, God's going to send somebody that's going to move you forward. Some of us need a push. Sister Brandon, somebody's going to come your way that's going to push you forward. Melissa, that's it. Somebody's going to come to you that's going to move you forward. We decree and declare, Glenda, up and forward. No down and back, only up and forward. You hear me? We've come too far, y'all. God has proven himself. We've seen too many people get blessed. So we want God to bless us with a next kind of blessing. I stand next in Jesus' name. Y'all, if you believe in Noonday Prayer, please sow a seed. Go to Cash App, any seed, 5, 10, 20. Those of you who've already sown, I thank God for you. Let's keep sowing because, listen, I don't squander it. I use it for ministry calls. And I thank God for you. This Sunday at 6, I'll be in Atlanta, Georgia for our prayer clinic at 6 p.m. at the Faith Apostolic Church. And God's blessing us. That prayer clinic is going on 10 years old. This will be going into the 10th year this year. Last Sunday, we was in Philadelphia at Jones Temple on Paris Street. I'm there in the Philly area on third Sundays at 6. God is blessing these prayer clinics, y'all. And I decree and I declare it's the Lord's doing, and it's marvelous in our eyes. I give him all the glory. So Sunday, if you're in the Atlanta area, I grew up in the time of church where we had night service. No, people don't do night services no more. You know, folk feel like they just go and that's it. When they go for their 90 minutes of worship, that's it. But some of us dealing with a demon that's going to take more than 90 minutes to get rid of. You need some folk that's going to put some oil on you, pray, read the scriptures, and believe God and tell the devil, loose your hold. That's what the old folk used to tell the devil, loose around here, loose them and let them go. So we believe in God. That's what those prayer clinics for, that we get intimate care. Sometimes you just need two or three people to touch and agree that your money changed, touch and agree that you get the promotion, touch and agree that you get the house, touch and agree that you get your family member saved. In Jesus' name, I decree and I declare that it is saved. Gonna bless us. Today's Noonday Prayer focus is for divine connections. Please, I need some of your associates. Go to Cash App, $ Prayer Clinic. Somebody write it in there for me. That's it. Go to YouTube, subscribe to Dwight Follins. Go to Dwight Follins and hit that page. You'll see my picture and subscribe to my YouTube channel. We decree and declare that the hand of the Lord is moving now. And we decree and declare that the peace of God is restoring us now. Good to see you, Minister Mark Hill. I believe God that this is the year for divine connections. That's what we're praying for. Y'all keep typing it in. This is an interactive prayer. This is Noonday Prayer and it's interactive. You got to type in there on you. We type, I have divine connections. If something is said in prayer that you like it, say amen. When you show your activity, it lets us know that we are agreeing in the spirit. And there's a spiritual law that cannot be denied, y'all. There's a spiritual law that can't be reversed. And you know what it says? If any two of us touch and agree on any one thing, it shall come to pass. That's a law, and it has to happen in the spirit. And we decree and declare that we have divine connections. Now, we're going to bring Noonday Prayer to a close, but as I bring it to a, thank you, Junior, for posting that. As I bring Noonday Prayer to a close, you got to say to yourself, I have divine connections. I have the great, thank you, Sister Sonia. You just sowed a seed and it just hit to my iPad. I decree and I declare that the Holy Spirit is giving us divine connections in this year. We read Ezekiel chapter 37. We read 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 10. Somebody put those scriptures on there for me. I'm going to say them again. Ezekiel chapter 37 verses 1 through 14. Verses 1 through 14. 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 10. We read those today and we are meditating. When he told them in Ezekiel, prophesy to the bones. That's what this Noonday Prayer is. We're prophetically speaking into our 2020 year. I don't want you just to look at this prayer one time. Go back and read it and listen to it again. Read those scriptures again. I see my mama just logged in. I love you, mama. I'm so proud of my mom. My mom is doing outreach ministry as well. She did her first outreach ministry in a hair salon. So many people are opening opening doors for her. God is taking ministry out of the walls of the church. You got people now who will never go back to church because they've been hurt. People who don't want to go to church because they don't like what they see and experience. So we got to take the church to them. We got to go to where they are and let them know God still loves them and that he wants to give them hope, help, and healing. So we decree and declare today's noonday prayer is for divine connections. I'm excited about the summer. During the summer, I'm going to be taking my mom with me on some of these prayer clinics. She's going to be journeying with me on some of my engagements. I have a powerful mother, and I love her with all my heart. My mom spoke life into me. I'm getting moved now. My mom spoke life to me in a crazy situation. You got to make sure you got somebody in your life that when the enemy wants to kill you, they tell you, no, that's not what God said. I decree and I declare that we have divine connections in Jesus' name. God, we thank you for this noonday prayer. We thank you for divine connections. We thank you for Ezekiel chapter 37, where you told us to prophesy to the bone, and every bone fell in place. Every bone went to its right area. That's why we're saying divine connection. The hip bone didn't go to the ankle. The knee didn't go to the shoulder. Y'all help me in here. God said prophesy to the bones. And when he did, everything fell in place. We also prayed and we read and meditated on 1 Corinthians 1 and 10. 1 Corinthians 1 and 10 is so powerful. It says, now I plead you, brethren, by the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that you speak the same thing and that there be no division among you, that you be perfectly joined together in the same mind, in the same judgment. That's what we're praying for. I see my big sister tuned in, Evangelist Rogers. Now, y'all, she's a powerhouse, a mighty intercessor. And I thank God for her. Today's noonday prayer is for divine connections. Pastor Stephen Holden, I'll see you Sunday in Atlanta. Pastor Stephen is my little brother doing great things in ministry. Evangelist Rogers is a mighty woman of God. She's a true intercessor. She taught me some powerful things about the prophet's prayer and the prophet's reward. And I'll be forever grateful for that, Evangelist Rogers. Please, those of you who are tuning in, we just prayed today's noonday prayer for divine connections. Begin to type it in the comment so I'll know that you're in agreement. I have divine connections in 2020. God's going to connect us with right people. We read Ezekiel 37, how he prophesied and everything came in place. Good to see you, Dr. Rich Christie. A mighty man. Rich Christie is from he's from the Berean church in the spirit. He is a learner and a student of God's word. I like hanging around people like that. So I pray, Brother Rich, as you continue to study God's word, that his word will become alive in you and your family. And everything you touch in 2020, Rich Christie, will prosper. That this will not be a barren or a dry year for you. I speak it in Jesus' name, that this will be one of the most powerful years that the Christian household has ever seen. In Jesus' name, divine connections is what we're believing God for. Type it in there. I have divine connections in 2020. I see my sister in love. I don't like to say sister-in-law. Sister Tanya Pender, I love you. Thank you for that word you gave me today, this morning. I decree and I declare God's connecting us with people who are not going to let us die, who are not going to let us drown, who are not going to let us fall. You got to be around people who will give you. Thank you, Gabby, for putting those scriptures up there. Please, please, y'all grab hold and read them before the sun go down today and say out loud, I have divine connections. I got to let you go in noonday prayer, but I need you all to please sow a seed. Sow a seed. I don't care what it is, 5, 10, 20. Let me know that you believe in the prayer clinics. You believe in noonday prayer. Every seed is going toward ministry, and I thank God for you. Go to Cash App, $ prayer clinic. I'm going to close up prayer, but I decree and I declare those who have been pulled into this noonday prayer, you're not here on mistake. I told God only bring people into noonday prayer that need what we're praying for, that need what we're focusing on. And today's focus is for divine connections. If you're in Jacksonville or you want to participate in noonday prayer personally, please, we do noonday prayer at the Southside Church of God in Christ. I'm there second and fourth Tuesday of every month, second and fourth Tuesday at Southside Church of God in Christ on Emerson. We're there at 12 noon praying. And after we come out of prayer, we obey the Spirit of the Lord, and we pray over each other. People have been healed. People have been delivered just from people getting together. That's what the old saints used to do. They used to come, go house to house and have prayer meeting. And we're going back to that because prayer works. So I'm going to release this noonday prayer. But if you came in, You can type in there, I have divine connections. We prayed, we decreed and declared that this is the year for divine connections. God's going to connect us with people that's going to help us fix our credit. God's going to connect us with people that's going to help you get the business on the go. God's going to connect you with people who's going to give you the right information so you can start school again and finish your degree. That's something that I have in my heart. I got too close and I want to finish what I've started. And I decree and I declare that God's going to set us up with people who are going to make this thing easy. We decree and declare divine connections are happening to us in Jesus' name. We decree and declare that God is shifting us from now to next, and our next is greater than our now. Y'all begin to type it, and please, when we log off, please share this, like and share this noonday prayer. This noonday prayer was for divine connections. And if you've been drawn to this noonday prayer, apparently God is trying to tell you that he want to connect you with new people this year. Some of us have not grown because we've been stagnated. We've been around people who are doing the same thing for 10 or 20 years. See you, OJ. I love you, OJ. You're a powerful man, not only just in the spirit, but economically. OJ, it is my prayer that God connect you with people that's going to push you to the next level, that's going to push you to where you need to be, bro. You work for so many people, but I believe God is really want you to work for yourself, man, and you'll see an overflow of finances. I decree and I declare this. So Prince Day, I decree and declare, Deacon Day, for you and your family, divine connections. After you finish this phase of life that you're in, God's going to send somebody else that's going to take you to a next level. You hear me? And you won't just be a man of one property. You'll own many properties. You'll leave a legacy for your children. You and your wife will be without struggle. That's my prayer for you, brother, Minister Mark Hill, that the Lord send you divine connections, that he won't make anything difficult anymore. He'll bring the high places down. He'll make the crooked way straight. And that's my prayer for you, Minister Mark Hill, that the Holy Spirit will do that for you. Wesley Ann, be patient. Wait on the Lord. God's going to lead you to the right house. He's going to lead you to the right location. And it's going to be just what you want plus more. And I decree and I declare, we're going to close out noonday prayer. But the Spirit of the Lord, we thank you for blessing us. Thank you for noonday prayer. Thank you for how you came in and communed with us. Thank you for how you supped with us. Thank you for how you abided with us. Thank you for how you gave us reassurance that 2020 is our year of divine connections. God, we decree and declare everybody that came into this noonday prayer that you will connect us with the right people at the right time and give us the right miracle, the right blessing, the right promotion. We thank you that we have divine connections in 2020. We believe the report of the Lord, and we decree and declare that it is so. What is your report? Your report is your word. So we trust your word, and your word has everything we need. Thank you for divine connections in Jesus' name. As I close noonday prayer, do me a favor, like and share this. Put this on your page. Let's increase these numbers. Prayer don't hurt nobody. I need you to help me be a blessing to so many people when it comes to ministry. I need you to go to YouTube, hit Dwight Follins, type in Dwight Follins. You'll see my face. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. If I could get 1,000 people, YouTube will be a blessing to me and my ministry. And I need that blessing because I want to advance the kingdom of God. Also, last but not leastly, I need everybody that's been on this noonday prayer and you have cash out, sow a seed. It'll help with ministry. It helps with travel. And I decree and I declare that whatever seed you sow is $prayer clinic. Go to cash out, $prayer. Every seed you sow will come back to you in finances and favor. That's my prayer for everybody that's ever seeded into me. The Lord, it'll come back in finances, favor, and good health. Finances, favor, and good health in Jesus' name. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May he cause his face to shine upon you. May this be one of the best years that you've ever had, because you have divine connections. Be blessed. Be well.